and she couldn't open it. She cried a lot for a long time. Then she felt very thirsty. She found a bottle on the floor and she picked it and drank the contents of the bottle, thinking it to be water. But it was not water, it was actually kerosene. Her father had to come back home from office, call 2-3 men and break open the door for her. Good evening, Toastmaster.
Good evening.
Good evening.
And fellow Toastmasters. This naughty little girl's name is Meenu. She was born and brought up in a small town called Erode, which is in Tamil Nadu. She has 3 brothers and 1 sister. As a small child, she has troubled her parents a lot. She would run to the bathroom every now and then, open the tap and stand under the running water. For her mom, it was a fastidious task to keep her away from the bathroom. On her first day to school, when she was forced to get down her dad's lap, she caught hold of his pocket and pulled it hard. And finally, she succeeded in tearing it. Her father had to go back home with a half-torn pocket hanging on his shirt. At school, she would love Sister Herold because Sister Herold spoke very good English. She would just wait to listen to her classes. And her English textbook, she would always complete before even the teacher starts teaching the first lesson. For vacation, she would always come to Bangalore to her grandma's place and have nice time with her cousins. Even her cousins spoke very good English. She would always go back to Erode with a wish that she should speak very good English. At school, she was an average student and till 6th standard, when a small incident changed everything. For the first term in the physics subject, she failed. She was very sad because she had failed for the first time. She went home and she cried a lot. She thought for some time and then decided that she's going to work hard hereafter. The next term, she got the first mark in the whole class. Her paper was circulated in the whole class and her ma'am was very happy with her. Whole class clapped for her. After that, there was no looking back. Back home from school, she would water the plants in the garden at the backyard and play with her friends and even her brothers. With her brothers, she would love playing cricket. But she would get out in the first or the second ball itself. Once when they were playing cricket, they saw a squirrel entering the house. So all the kids, all excited, ran behind the squirrel, which entered their parents' room. All the kids ransacked their parents' room and finally it was she who found the squirrel in the gap between the cupboard and the wall. She put her hand in the gap, caught hold of the squirrel's tail and pulled it hard. It was a shock when everybody saw what came in her hand. It was the squirrel's tail, only the tail and not the squirrel. They saw the squirrel running towards the garden after that. In school, they had a zoo where they would keep monkey, fox, rabbits and pigeons in different cage. She was holding one of the cage where the monkey was sitting in the extreme corner and eating something. She was watching the monkey. For some time, she got distracted and she looked somewhere else. All of a sudden, the monkey came and attacked and caught her finger. Went very badly. She had to pull her finger out of the monkey's mouth. Once she had been to Palani with her family, her brother who was 1 year younger to her, was standing next to her and was teasing the monkeys again. So one of the monkeys got angry and decided to take the revenge. Her brother, anticipating the danger, ran away from the place. She stood over there thinking the monkey will not harm her because she's not done anything. The monkey attacked her and again bit her. After school, she would come home, and as I told, she would play with her friends and all. At school, she was just an average student, and in the higher classes after 6th standard, she started really performing well. She did her 10th, 12th, scored 80 and 90% each. Then she took an arbitrary decision to join BSc Chemistry. She again backed university rank in BSc Chemistry. After completing chemistry, she decided to pursue her interest in English language. So she joined MA in English Literature. She completed, wrote her exam, first year exam, and the next week she got married. After marriage, her name changed to Janvi. So everyone calls me Janvi now. She's married to Nirmal, who's working as an associate travel manager with Infosys. We have two children, Tanya, 11 years old, and Jay, 4 years. After Tanya's birth, I work for Navras Travel, issuing flight tickets, and then with Windsor Manor Hotel, selling dining membership cards. After Jay completed 3 years in joint school, I again thought of completing my master's degree, and did my second year, wrote my exam just 2 months back, second year MA Literature exam. I'm waiting for the results. So I was looking for a platform where I can practice my communication skills and speak unambiguously like any other great speaker. I found out that Toastmasters, Sunshine Toastmasters, is an exemplary place where I can hone my, my communication skills and even rejuvenate myself. So I'm glad that I'm with Sunshine Toastmasters.